Hi, I'm Kate. In this video, we're going to talk about how to fix the link you followed has expired error. Before we do anything, make sure that you have a backup of your site. Also, some of these fixes involve copying code from the blog post that corresponds to this video and pasting to your website's files with the help of cPanel or FTP. If you don't know how to use these methods, you can learn with the knowledge base article that we've linked in the description. Okay, now we can start the video. We'll cover what causes this error and a few ways to fix it. You can skip to the part you prefer with the timestamps in the description. Beginners usually find this error difficult to solve because it doesn't specify what is wrong. It's actually caused because the user tried to upload a theme or plugin that exceeded the file limit. This limit could be imposed by the hosting company or set up in the WordPress installation itself. You can always check the configuration values in the site health page in the tools section of the admin area. Another quick way to discover the maximum file size is opening Media, Add New, and checking under the Drop Files to Upload area. Even if the upload limits in your installation and hosting company are big enough, WordPress will still be unable to upload larger files when the execution time goes over the maximum. Now let's go over a few solutions for the link you followed has expired error. First, how to increase the limits by adding code to your functions.php file. The upload max size value represents the maximum file size you're allowed to upload. Post max size is the maximum size for all data in a post, including text, images, and other media. Max execution time is the maximum amount of time a script can run before being aborted, even if it isn't finished. Besides using the cPanel or FTP methods that we mentioned in the beginning of the video, you can open the theme file editor in the appearance section of WordPress. Copy this code from our blog post, paste it at the bottom of the file, and save the changes. Another way to increase the limits is by adding code to the htaccess file. You can get the code from the blog post that corresponds to this video. The link is in the description. In the plugin's general settings, open the Edit htaccess tab. Or you can access your website via FTP and download the htaccess file from the root folder. If you don't want to edit your functions.php or htaccess file, you can increase the limits in the php.ini file. First, check if your site's public HTML folder in the server already contains the file through FTP or cPanel. If the file doesn't exist, you can create a blank file, add the code snippet from our blog post, and upload it to your website. The last solution you can do yourself is updating the PHP version. Even though WordPress still works with previous versions, the community recommends PHP 7.4 or higher to ensure full compatibility. Many hosting companies offer this option in their control panels. Search for PHP configuration or a similar name. If none of these solutions work, you should consider contacting your host provider and discussing upload limits with them. If this tutorial helped you, give it a like. If you have any questions, click on the link in the description to open our free support ticket. You can find other tutorials in our knowledge base at rankmath.com/kb.